Taking video, not picture, sinner.
I don't want you to touch me. Oh, yeah, Jesus loves, but the question is, do you love Jesus? If you don't love Jesus, you're going to hell. Oh, you don't love Jesus. If you love Jesus, you obey Jesus. But because you don't obey Jesus, you don't love Jesus. If you obey Jesus, you'll stop being a drunkard. You'll stop being a fornicator. You'll stop dressing immodestly. Oh, I'm not going anywhere, sinner. I'm not going anywhere. All the other religions are wrong.
Stop fucking taking pictures of me.
You can leave, sinner. It's freedom of the press.
You have a potty mouth that you have.
Freedom of the press.
Oh, no, no. This is the best thing a sinner can do. This is the best thing anyone can ever do with their life. It's the preach the gospel of the Lord Jesus Christ.
Don't threaten me or have you arrested, okay?
Yes. Oh, no, I'm not a drunkard.
So?
Well, it's called freedom of the press.
Freedom of the press. You're in a public place.
Well, go ahead. I don't care. Videotape me all you want. We're not Nazis, sinner.
I told you. Wait 10 minutes and I'll talk to you.
I'm not a homosexual. I'm married. No, I'm married.
You're a fucking baggage.
No, you're the one out here with your friend. Oh, no, sinner. Sir. I'm not a monosexual. Well, you're drunk. You're a drunkard. You need to stop it. God bless, sinner. What's that? I can tell by the way you're slurring your speech that you're a drunkard. God bless you, sinner. God bless you, sinner. God bless you, sinner. No, you're not touching my microphone.
It's illegal to photograph people without their consent.
No, it's not.
Well, I'm sorry. Freedom of the press. My microphone.
No, that's not.
You better learn the Constitution, young man.
You know, you have to ask
well, Jesus, Jesus doesn't just love, Jesus hates too. Yeah, Psalm 5:5, sinner. You sinners hate this verse, Psalm 5:5. God hates all the workers of iniquity. Yeah. Oh, he does so. Oh, yeah, he does. Oh, he sure does. God hates all the workers of iniquity, the Bible says. Oh, I don't have to share your microphone. You're not a Christian. You have a filthy mouth. A potty mouth. Yes, you are.
God hates the workers of iniquity.
What are you talking about? You never were a Christian. You have a filthy mouth. You need to get a new heart, new desire, sinner. Oh, no, 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 sinner. You make yourself a non-Christian by living in your sin. No, you shouldn't. Maybe do, you'll be in big trouble. I'm not lowering anything. You can go across the street with the bird if you want. But you can go across the street with this bird if you want. But if you're still a sinner, God bless you, sinner. No, don't touch my microphone.
That's not good.
Yeah, so you sinners, the only people who don't like the preaching of righteousness are sinners who love their sin and hate God. You're just a sin-loving God-hater. That's what you are.
Two-legged
devil. Yeah, you are.
You're
a two-legged devil is what you are.
Wait.
Jesus drunk
the wine. Why can't we drink the beer?
Oh, yeah. You have sin.
Yeah. Jesus drunk the wine. Why can't we drink the beer?
Yes, I am. Yes, I am. No, it doesn't. Don't read your Bible, scholar.
Why are you hating on me?
I'm Catholic.
Oh, so first you want to talk about the Bible. Now you're going to question whether Jesus is real or not? Oh, yeah. Oh, you said, don't touch me. Yeah, Jesus was real. He sure is real. He's still alive today. He rose from the grave on the third day. What, sinner?
Jesus drunk the wine.
But you're getting drunk. There's a difference. Jesus never was a drunkard. You're a drunkard. You're blaspheming God. No, it isn't. Where is it, sinner? Tell me, Bible scholar. Tell me, Bible scholar, where does the... That's right. If you think I'm judgmental, wait till you meet God. You'll see how judgmental he is. You've been cast in a lake of fire. I'll win a lot more souls than you will with your drunken parent. Oh, yeah, I know Jesus very well. Oh, yeah, I talk to him every day. Oh, you haven't, sir. Sometimes he does, yeah. Yeah. He says, go tell those sinners to repent. That's what he tells me to say. No, no. Jesus doesn't have a filthy mouth like you do, sinner. Oh, I never said that word. I haven't said a cuss word in I don't know how long. Probably about 10 or 12 years. Oh, no, I don't swear. I let my yes be yes and my no be no, according to the Bible. You guys need to stop being drunkards. You were out here for happy hour, weren't you? You all got drunk before 7 or 9, weren't you? What are you going to do? Don't touch me. The Bible never says that Jesus sinned or Jesus was a drunkard. The Bible says that Jesus was holy. He was a perfect, sinless sacrifice.
I'm Catholic, it don't matter.
Hey, do you have the Bible?
I got Sunday church.
All right, can you look up a scripture passage for me?
No.
Why not?
Don't touch me.
Okay, so Jesus only says what you say. Is that right? Jesus doesn't say what's in the Bible. Only
well, Jesus can forgive you, sinners.
Suck my dick.
You're a homo, aren't you? You're a homo? No, thanks.
No, you're a homo.
Hey, that's like right there.
You're a homo.
You're thinking people like
I'm not. I'm married. Wait.
Jesus said you can't say homo to somebody.
Hey, you touch me again, sinner. I'm going to get the cops. You
want me to call the police?
You understand, young man?
Should I call the police now?
Sober up, young man.
You go to jail. You do that again, and I promise you I'm going to charge you. You understand?
Are you fucking sad?
But Matthew 7:1 does not say you can't judge.
Sinner.
Here's a question.
Pray for people.
You are a sinner. I'm a saint. I'm living holy.
You're living like the devil. Your prayers aren't even heard.
That's one of the deadliest sins you can get.
They're wrong. That's a terrible thing at the end of the world.
Hey!
I'm not a homo for the last time. No, I'm not. I'm a heterosexual. I'm married. I have 3 children at home, and I have 1 more coming away. I don't know when Christ is going back. He said no one knows the day or the hour. Only the Father knows. Because I'm preaching right now. You want to talk to my friend? You can talk to him, or you can talk to my other friend over here. No, I'm not a sinner. I'm not going to hell. I'm not a homo sinner. I'm not a homo. I'm not a homo like you are. No, sinner. I'm not a homo like you. You don't watch too much pornography.
Sir, I want to talk to you guys. Stop.
I'm not interested in talking to you.
I want to talk to you.
You're a drunkard. There's no reason to even
he says that God ain't going to come back.
No.
That's not what he said. You're not listening.
He said he don't know. But in the Bible it says...
Oh, it sure is.
I don't remember what the Bible says.
It sure is.
Okay, here's what the Bible actually says.
Jesus commands all men everywhere to repent because coming a day when you will judge the world and righteous. You're not my brother. You're a child of the devil. You're not my brother. You're not my brother. You're a child of the devil. I'm of God the Father.
You can't say that and be fucking...
I'm of God the Father. I love him. I'm one of his children.
The word of God.
This is the word of God.
You're a sinner. You're a sinner. You're a sinner. You can't be doing that.
Why? You say you're a sinner. You say you're a
I'm not saying I'm a sinner.
You're not saying that.
No, I'm not.
But your drunkenness indicates you're a sinner.
I am not drunk. I have
you're going to be in trouble with God.
You're stumbling around. You got red bleary eyes. I'm talking to your friend right now. You're being rude to your friend. You're very your friend. Yes, you are. Control yourself. Stop being so emotional.
You're emotional.
Sir, yes, I'm
hearing
the sun.
It says, God will forgive every sin. And it says, God will come back eventually. God will come back eventually. But he's supposed to come back, it's in 3 years.
I'm going to fuck.
that's none of that's true what you just said. None of that's according to the Bible. You're making this stuff up.
Yeah, I made up.
Hey, God don't forgive me, Sam.
You need to go drink some water, man. You need to listen. You need to go drink some water.
Talk to me, bro.
You need to repent of your sin. That's not what I said.
That's exactly what you said.
No, the Bible says drunkards go to hell. I don't want you to go to hell.
I'm not drunk. I haven't took one sip of beer.
He's drunk.
I'm not.
What do you want?
I'm not nothing. I'm in Spring Break and I'm having a good time. I don't want to hear this right here. I go to Sunday school.
You're fucking boring to be a fucking sign in a microphone.
Quit cussing to a preacher, you idiot.
Stop your sinning, sinner. Stop your sinning.
Don't listen.
God bless you, son.
Hey, bro.
God bless you. God bless you.
Don't cuss.
More accusations.
All your sin will hurt you is a place, the everlasting lake of fire. All your sin is going to cost you in the end is your soul.
Yeah, and you get to save as many souls as you turn
around. Oh, I can't save any soul, sinner. They have to save themselves. The Bible says, draw near to God, and he will draw near to you. Cleanse your hands, you sinners. Purify your hearts, you double-minded. Lament and mourn and weep. Let your laughter turn to mourning and your joy to gloom. Well, you need to repent, sinner. You're on your way to hell. And your joy to gloom, humble yourself under the mighty hand of God. He will lift you up. He will lift you up. You need more wrath, sinner. You're using the grace of God's license to sin. You need more wrath. We need more holy wrath in this world. Too many people are justifying themselves. Saying, oh, God loves me. Go out and get drunk. God loves me. They go out and be a fornicator. God loves me. They go out and dress half naked. No, God doesn't love you that way. God has a holy hatred for those kind of people, a holy anger for those kind of people. And if you won't stop your sinning, God won't turn from his anger. God is willing to turn from his holy anger if you'll turn from your wicked sin. But if you won't turn from your wicked sin, God will not turn from his holy anger. God is angry with the wicked every day. That means you, fornicator. God's angry with you. That means you, drunkard. God is angry with you. That means you, woman who's dressing half naked. God is angry with you. You need to stop your sinning and follow Christ.
I'll take his question.
What's your point?
Well, we're all born naked, so why?
So why do you have clothes on right now, then?
Right.
So take your clothes off if that's what you really believe. But the fact of the matter, just because you're born naked, you're not born with clothes on, doesn't mean you should walk around half naked. You know in your conscience, you know right from wrong, you know it's wrong to dress half naked. Your clothes are meant to cover you up. They're not meant to seduce. Your clothes are not meant to reveal or to entice or cause men to lust after you. Your clothes are meant to cover. To cover. Cover up. The only person to see your body is your spouse. A monogamous marital relationship. That's the only person who's to see your body. Not every Tom, Dick, and Harry who walks around in front of Razzles or on the beach. What's that, Senator?
What about your doctor?
No, he doesn't see me.
He's going to get checked. You're dirty. You can't.
Okay, Senator. What a foolish person you are. You have no idea what you're talking about.
You have to
go into Razzles.
But you do?
Oh, you already are drunk. Well, I'm sure you probably are. Doesn't surprise me.
Love your neighbors, you would love God.
Oh yeah, I'm loving my neighbor. I'm rebuking my neighbor. God bless you, sinner. You stop being drunkards, be sober-minded.
You're a liar.
Drunkards, don't you realize what you're doing to your body? Destroying your brain cells, destroying your liver, destroying your kidney, throwing up and puking in the morning, having a headache in the morning, having dry mouth in the morning. Your body's screaming at you to stop being drunkards. No, sinner. I'm not going to shut up. No, sinner. No. Stop being a drunkard. Stop being a fornicator.
You can't call them sinners. They are.
Okay. You're
right.
That
can't be the first thing you tell them, because if you antagonize someone, that's the first thing you do.
He told me he's not a Christian.
Yeah, I know. I'm not. I, like I said.
People are from Kentucky. Where are you from?
Central Kentucky.
Oh, I'm from Louisville.
Really? Yeah, we'll be up there. You go to school up there?
No, I'm not a
I go to University of Kentucky.
Right. What's your major?
Music.
What's your name?
Antonio.
John, how you doing,
we're
Antonio?
We're here with Campus Crusade for Christ.
Oh, yeah. Yeah. All right. How y'all doing?
You're walking into Razzles tonight. You're on the broad path, leads to destruction. You get off the broad path, leads to destruction, and begin a narrow road to leads to life. The narrow road
you all
Jesus
from Campus
Christ,
Crusade
said,
for Christ?
I am the way, I am the truth, I am the life. No one comes to the Father but by me. So you trust in Christ, believe in Christ, follow Christ. If you won't follow and believe and trust in Christ, then you're still in your sins. And God will give you what you deserve for your sins. That's eternal hell forever and ever.
Ever and ever.
Is your soul really worth it? Is your sin really worth your soul? Is your fornication, your lust really worth your soul? Is your porn watching really worth your soul? I knew you were a porn watcher. Is your drunkenness really worth your soul? You need to stop your sinning. Stop living for your wickedness. It's going to cost you your soul. What's the profit of the man that gains the whole world and loses his soul in the end? Or will a man give an exchange for his soul? You willing to exchange a little dirty dancing for your soul? You willing to exchange a little lust after women for your soul? Are you willing to exchange a little drunkenness for your soul? Are you willing to exchange a little bit of pot smoking for your soul? Are you willing to exchange any other kind of sin for your soul? What a foolish thing that is. No sin is worth your soul. No sin is worth your eternity. Why is that? What's terrible about it? Why is it terrible? You don't think you deserve hell? Have you ever lied before? What does that make you? Revelation 21:8 says every liar shall have their part in the lake of fire. So I deserve hell. I deserve hell. That's why I need Jesus. Oh no, not just one time. Don't lie. You've lied more than once.
You believe in what you're saying.
Have you ever been a drunkard before?
I'm drunk right.
Have you been a fornicator before? Have sex outside of marriage?
What
about masturbation?
Oh, yeah.
Porn watching?
Oh, yeah.
You're in trouble with God. You're in big, big trouble with God. You need to stop it. If you don't stop it, you're going to go to hell. Jesus died for you because you deserve hell.
And you haven't?
Oh, no. I've done all those things, but I stopped it.
That's a joke.
That's not a joke, sinner. Your soul's not a joke. Eternity's not a joke. Christ dying on the cross, he's not a joke. You're a joke if you saying you're sinning, go to hell for your sin. You're not your father or devil. If you stay that way, you're a joke.
You're saying things that you've done.
Oh no, I've done a lot of those things. No, I'm not. I stopped it. I repented. I stopped my sinning and I'm following Jesus.
So if I do those things and then if I buy a megaphone,
I'm not buying a megaphone. You need to turn to Christ. You surrender your life to Him wholly.
Praise the Lord.
You need to surrender your life to Christ. Surrender your heart to Christ. Hey, let me give you an admonition from the book of James. Draw near to God and He will draw near to you. Cleanse your hands, you sinners. Purify your hearts, you know, and lament and mourn and weep. Let your laughter return to mourning, your joy to gloom. Humble yourself under the mighty hand of God, and He will lift you up, the Bible says. Seek the Lord while He may be found. Call upon Him while He is near. Let the wicked forsake His way and the unrighteous men his thoughts. Let him return to the Lord, and He will have mercy on him. To our God, for He will abundantly pardon. That's God's message for every sinner. You can come to Christ with the tax collector and say, forgive me, a sinner. Humbly, with contriteness and brokenness over your sin, knowing that you've sinned against a holy and just God. He'll give you what you deserve, and except you repent, you will perish. Except you turn, you will burn, Jesus said. Luke 13:3-5. Except you repent, you will perish. You call yourself a Christian. You think because you went to church yesterday that you're on your way to heaven, you're deceived. You are deceived. 1 John 2:3 says this. By this we know that we know Him, if we keep His commandments. Whereas they know Him does not keep His commandments, and liar, and truth is not in Him. You better start keeping God's commandments, otherwise you're going to hell. Hebrews 5:9, because the author of eternal life to all those who obey Him. That obeying Jesus, you're on your way to hell. You better stop your sinning. You better stop your sinning. Stop your immodest dress. Stop. Oh, you think that's funny, sinner. Your amount of stress is going to cast you in a lake of fire, and you won't be laughing then. Better put some more clothes on. They're meant to cover you up, not to reveal, seduce, entice, or cause men to lust after you. What you immodest women don't realize, you have a large millstone around your neck. You're drowning in a deep sea called sin, and pretty soon, if you don't repent of your sins, you die in your sins, you'll be drowning in a deep sea called a lake of fire for all of eternity. Just stop your sinning. Jesus said, go and sin no more, lest a worse thing happen to you. And he said it to a man who was lame for 38 years, who he had healed. What's worse than being lame for 38 years? Nothing here in the physical realm. What's worse than that is going to hell forever. Suffering in a lake of fire forever. The worm is not dying, the fire is not quenched. The fire never goes out. And your worst enemy in hell will be your conscience, and your memory will be completely intact. You remember every time you heard a silly little street preacher in the corner preaching the gospel to you, and you'll be in torment forever because you didn't obey the gospel of Jesus Christ. Well, I am leading by example. I sure am. I'm definitely leading by example. This is what Jesus did, and I'm following it. Says who? Are you leading by example? Are you a drunkard? You're a drunkard. You're telling me to lead by example, but you're smoking and you're drunk? That seems like hypocrisy to me. You take a log out of your own eye. We're trying to get a speck out of mine. Oh, I am leading by example. This, I wish every Christian would become just like me. I wish every Christian would do this very thing every night here at Razzle. If every Christian in Dakota Beach, every professing Christian who needs to do this, Razzle would close down. Sinners would be converted.
Amen.
This place wouldn't be here. I wouldn't have to come out here because all you wicked sinners would be so tormented in your conscience. I am leading by example. No, I'm not going to shut my mouth. No. Jesus didn't say shut your mouth. He said in Romans chapter 10, verse 14. How can they believe on that word? How can they hear without a preacher? Go to all the world and preach the gospel, Mark 16, 15 says. Jesus didn't say shut your mouth. He said the exact opposite, sir. If you're a professing Christian and keep your mouth shut, you're not really a Christian. You don't love God. You don't love people. You love yourself. You're selfish if you won't preach the gospel. If you won't witness to people who are on their way to hell. How selfish is this? To know that people are on their way to hell, to know you have eternal life, and not offer to others who are on their way to hell. How selfish is that? It's the most selfish thing someone can do. That's why we're out here tonight. We're being loving. You might not think it's love, you might not feel like you're being loved, but the fact of the matter is, if we love you, we'll tell you the complete truth, the whole truth, nothing but the truth. We tell you an action, but Jesus loves you. Pray this little prayer. We're telling you a whole lot. We're deceiving you. Listen, you're straight
to
hell.
It broke the law, huh?
You'll think you're a Christian on your way to hell, but you're actually going. You'll think you're a Christian on your way to heaven, you're actually going to hell. And here we see a demonstration of the law taking effect upon this vehicle. This person parked here illegally. And now the law is taking effect, and their car is being towed. But you think this is the law right here? The law of the land being enforced? God's law being enforced is greater punishment.
Oh, that's great.
God's law will not be towing your precious little car away. God's law will punish every sinner with everlasting destruction, the Bible says. You're sitting against an infinite holy God. There'll be an infinite punishment, which is an eternal place called hell. And if the law of the land is enforced correctly, and God is infinite and holy and all-knowing, and all powerful, he will not let you escape punishment for one sin. Said you repent. The only way out of getting punishment for your sin is to trust in the Lord and Savior Jesus Christ, who shed his blood for you on the cross, died the just for the unjust, to reconcile sinners back to God. If you're not willing to do that, you're in trouble with God. You were made for a relationship with God, an eternal relationship with God the Father and his Son.
Won't be funny.
That's what you are made for. But if you're in your sin, you have no relationship with God. The Bible says in 1 John chapter 3, he who abides in
him. Hey dude, there's a dog in there.
Okay. Sin has never seen him nor known him. Sin is of the devil, the Bible says. And Christ came to destroy the works of the devil in your life. He destroys sin in your life. You need to stop your sinning.
Huh?
That's terrible.
Yeah.
You know, how many often
there's a dog in there?
How wicked is that? This person lose his car and his dog, but he broke the law.
Poor dog.
But you lose a lot more in danger than your car or your dog. You lose your very soul.
Animal abuse.
You lose your eternity.
That's a police tollway zone. How dumb is that? You got to be really drunk to park in a police tollway zone. You got to be really drunk to bat there.